Ladies, gentlemen, variations alike, I had the not-so-privilege of spending a frivolous few years in Tucson, Arizona, while I was working towards my law degree. It was, what, six-something months ago. Anyway, I had this cushy little night job working in a French bistro. It was called the Bistro Pier. Anyway. I had one night off a week. And I damn well look forward to it. This was a Thursday night. And every Thursday night, I'd go down there. And I'd dine. I'd order a cup of a good pal Joe. And I'd check out their soup of the day. Now, this bistro sucked. It was also going out of business, so not only would I go there and be pummeled with way too much pepper, but I'd go there to find their so-called soup of the day. It was actually their soup of last week, and then quickly it was the soup of their month, and you get the point. Except one time. I went down there, like I had 100 times before. I sat down with my old pal, Joe, opened up the menu, and was delighted to see the word vichyssoise written in big, bold baguette letters. I was ecstatic. Finally, something new, something different. It took him 45 minutes, but when the waiter finally arrived, I wasted no time at all. I dug straight in, but I quickly spat it out. It was cold. And I asked him, I did. I asked him. He said, "That's the way it's supposed to be served." And it broke me. If soup could be cold, what else could it be? What was soup? What could it be? How do we define it? And it dawned on me. Maybe you don't need to define it. Protein, vegetable, liquid, solid, age. Soup is all of life. Soup is us. Soup is Jane Fonda. It's soup. Chuck Berry is soup. The ladies, gentlemen, variations alike here today in the courtroom. Emerson Knit, I am soup. And Your Honor, my client is soup. Hey, we never discussed going rights. Oh.